Welcome back. On last week's episode, we added the doors to the overhead storage cabinets. On this week's episode, we have a visitor and something that you might all recognise. My door handles have come, so I decided to go for the gold. These have got like black, like a bit of a white pearl sort of on the front, and yeah, nice, like it's kind of like a brass, like a brassy gold, but they are really nice. So, and they're only quite small, but yeah, they've come, so I'm gonna get them on at the moment. We've got a bit of a surprise happening very shortly. So we've got somebody coming, and it might be something you recognise when it turns up. So, anyway, that'll happen shortly. But up until then, I'm going to get these handles on, and then we'll sort that bit out, and we will get something else done on the van. But I'll update you shortly. Sears. So this is his first van, the van that basically the van we travelled around in for a good while, and this what kind of started me doing like other conversions and stuff like that. But the guy has actually added a few bits, and he does all this resin finish, so he's actually added this resin finish to the cupboard doors, which looks absolutely mint. Really matches like the worktops floor, not floor, roof. He's added a rug in, but yeah, it's really nice to see it again, because we had some good memories in this van. So I'm gonna crack on with this little job, and then we'll be back on to the other silver van. So yeah, I just wanted to show you that. Quite nice to see it. Right, welcome back. Let's start getting something done. Today, we're gonna be doing, so we've got a toilet here, and what I've done is I've marked out the area where the toilet's gonna go. So I'm gonna be making the buddy seat. This is gonna be a fixed seat. So I've previously done where you like lift it off so you can get the toilet out and stuff like that. So this one's gonna be a fixed seat, and it's gonna have a drawer in it. Now, originally the drawer was gonna come out forwards along this way, but because of the step, I didn't think there'd be enough support on the drawer with your with the weight of somebody on the toilet. So decided to actually have the toilet in here like this, and then on a drawer that slides out into the middle that way. That'll also provide a bit of a backrest as well to the toilet, up against the fridge and the back, the bed here. I don't know if I've got enough plywood to make this, but I'm going to see how far I get with it, and then I'll possibly have to go out and get some ply. But we do need ply for the kitchen as well, which I've also marked out in there. So yeah, let's crack on with the making of this buddy seat. We'll see how it turns out. Let's move. Right guys, so we've got the buddy seat base. It's all built and it's all fixed in. Now we've got the drawer done as well. So the toilet's there and it's in the drawer. Let me show you the front of that. So yeah, that's the front of the drawer, and it's a bit awkward with this camera here. This bit's cut down for the release, the toilet release. We had a little issue with this, so this is all built up, and a couple of reasons I can't finish this right now. We've got a couple of hours and I can't finish it. The drawer runners are not going to come while later today, so that's a bit annoying, and I won't be able to do anything then because I have got stuff on later, so we can't do that. The other issue, the main issue that we had with this, is I've already extended this further than I wanted to, so we're already about, I don't know, if maybe 20mm, 30mm over this way, and that's to compensate for the size of the toilet and the drawer. When you put runners, drawer runners on, you've got your drawer like that, you've got your runner at the side, and then you've got what it fastens to. Now the issue, can you see this fridge? So the fridge has got a lip which comes out, and that comes out this far, so the door will open easy enough and not creating a big gap. So now this needs to be, I have this much to clear the fridge along here when it comes out. So the issue we had is getting a runner in there, getting the drawer, and having enough room without moving all this out. I'm using the drawer runners, I'm using them differently, I'm using them underneath the drawer. Now they're heavy duty and they do take a lot of weight, but using them in this way, I'm guessing that's not what the weight was put out at, if you get me. I'm guessing it was to use them in the proper way. Now, so by putting these underneath, what I'm doing, the front, when the front of the drawer goes on, it's going to be a very like minor gap that it's just going to hover along the floor when it comes out. And when you sit on it, sit on the toilet in the drawer, it should just press down to the floor to get the support on the front. I'm going to put two rubber feet towards the back end. So when it comes out, the front is going to support it at the front, and the rubber feet should be off the floor a little bit. And if there's any movement in them runners, that will then sit onto the back of the drawer. I'll just quick show you, and I'll put the toilet in the drawer, and you get a little bit more an idea. And then hopefully I can get it finished, and then just show you it finished just after this. It'll probably be a few days after, but I can just add it straight in, and then you can see what the finish looks like. But quickly, so if you just come down here, so I've put in these two 12mm plies here with a gap in the middle, because this is where these little rubber feet's going to run between these gaps. So I need that for that extra bit. So yeah, the runners are going to sit. You're going to have a runner on this one. You're going to have a runner along this one. And the drawer's just going to glide out on that. So I put this drawer in, and I'll just show you it like that. And then hopefully we can just cut to the clip of the finished article. Basically, this is it, how it is, and it's going to have a door on the front. This is going to be covered over with the seat cushions on. It's actually got a lip on the end to stop the cushion from sliding off. And that's about it, basically. So this is going to pull out this way once done, and then that's what it looks like from the side door, to tie in with the rest of the van. So yeah, let's just throw in the completed thing that will be done in a few days, and that will be the end of this video. So here's the buddy seat done, complete, and then we'll finish on that, and I'll see you on the next one.
I can hardly stand it. Another day of being lonely isn't how I planned this. And I have high expectations. They build me up to tear me down. I'm running out of patience. Cause I've been waiting so long, out here looking for love. Another day of being